hotel the next day. I'm pretty tired. I would say at least. Today is the second day of riding 100 miles a day with 100 unicycles for 10 days. And today we're going to be riding Angled Crest, which is a mountain ride. So we're going to be going on a mountain, and our wheels actually don't have the range for it. So we're bringing superchargers, and we're praying that we find a plug so that we're fine and not stranded. If we do get stranded, we're going to have to call an Uber, but we'll see what happens. You know, it's going to be a good time. We're going to pack waters. We're going to pack food. I'll get a couple drone shots if I have any time. Let's drink an energy drink, and let's go.
Hey, bud, come here. Come here, bud. Hi.
Hi. Oh, there you go. I'm talking in a deep voice because I'm a man. Okay, I'm not going to be taking the gimbal or the camera this time, which is what I'm using right now, because we are going on a ride in the middle of nowhere. And yesterday, I had a place to stop and set the stuff down, and if I really needed to, I could put it back in the truck. This time, we're going 90 miles in the mountains, so if I get too heavy, honestly, as you guys saw the lacerations on me yesterday from the bag weight, if I'm going 90 miles, I have extra food in here this time, I'll have a whole bunch of extra liquids in here, it's going to be heavier, it's going to weigh me down, and also, since my wheel doesn't have the range to make this ride the whole entire way, I need to be as light as possible. So adding an extra 30 pounds to my bag to get some sweet footage is not worth it for me being stranded out there needing an Uber. So we're going to cook some eggs, and then I'm going to be using my phone camera, and then I also got this GoPro that I probably won't use because I like this more. And I also got the Insta360 camera. I have the X3 and then the invisible stick.
Chilling at like 20 miles an hour because we have to make it 70 miles to the end of the thing, and I think we'll make it at like 5%, 3%, something like that. But there's also a campground that we've heard of, and it's a couple miles ahead. We don't know where it's at, and a lot of people don't know where it's at either, but it's a road that goes off to the side, and hopefully we can charge there, and then we'll be able to have some fun on the way down. We've gone 38 miles so far. A good amount left to go.
It took a while, but we finally met up with the group, and there is charging ports here, so thank goodness we made it on a couple percent left. We're just trying to make sure that they're live so we can actually get a charge from them. Let's see, we've been here probably 45 minutes. Mine was at 24% and it is now at 64. We might just make it.
I came down here to take a poop with my baby wipes in the wilderness. You gotta do what you gotta do.
I used that tree, FYI. I'm gonna sit down and talk with you guys on the importance of doing your research. We were told that the V13s don't make this ride that we did today, and they didn't. And the only reason we made it is because we bought these really expensive, super duper fast chargers. So this is what happened. We went up in elevation, probably 4,000 feet, and we rode 20 miles an hour for a good 40 miles, and our wheels were at 18% and 24%. We thought we weren't gonna make it. We just kept going and kept going. Campsite, we kept looking for plugs. There was nothing. There was nothing at all. We were in the mountains. There was no service. Then we kept going and kept going and kept going. Then we finally found this one place where our group was after like an hour of not seeing them. And then we had the superchargers. So we got to plug in there for an hour and a half. And then we had to drive another 60 miles all the way up to 6,000 feet elevation. And then all the way back down. I checked, and it's kind of crazy too. I went exactly 100 miles from start of the day to the end of the day. 100 miles. I didn't go a tenth of a mile over, which is really insane. There's no reason for me to share that, except it's really cool. But if you go on something like this, a group ride, I want you to do your research. Look up the actual distance of the ride. maybe get a better wheel. But even if you're not going on EUCs, unicycles, you should probably make sure you have what's suitable for this. Now, normally, I took this, which is a piece of the gimbal that I took on the last trip yesterday. And it's got a good amount of weight to it because it's the RS3. It's not the Pro, and that's a lot bigger. But it's got a good amount of weight to it because it comes in this big kit, and I put all my camera equipment in it. The GoPros, the Insta360 cameras. I put my actual camera in there, the gimbal, some battery accessories, but it puts a lot of weight on my bag. If I went 100 miles with that in my bag, first off, that would have really hurt these again, just like yesterday as I was showing you guys at the end of the video. And then also with that extra amount of weight, I would have been stranded out there. We had one guy, he popped his tire and we had to put our thumb out and getting this random person to take him all the way back down the mountain to where he had service to get home and fix his wheel. So just do your research.
No, we...
not my good.
Yeah, they know. Well,
that was... Hey, dude, they fucking did.
Yeah, go backwards.
I just don't want to
buy one. What the fuck is wrong with that?
We told you.
Why did you do that? You're about to rip a nut off. Why are you guys laughing?
That's what we said.
That didn't do that.
Why would it do that?
I told you when you drop it too far to the side, it's going to take you out. It'd take me out. It'd fucking take my nut out.
Now, the only speculation with this one is it's weaker. So if you put all your weight forward, it's too much power for it. So don't put all your weight forward.
All right, yeah, put the pegs up. But we have to stand on it.
Brayden, this is probably a lot harder than the V12.
Yeah, it is very.
All right.
Yeah, it does the same thing. It spins.
Get on, Brady. Get on. Wait. Don't get up yet. Don't get up, man. What are you guys waddling?
He's such a...
Are you or I go in?
No, no, you get on first.
I told you it's pretty difficult, Aiden.
Brandon, come here. I need like,
I asked you for help and you wouldn't help me.
I was busy.
You were not busy. You were busy recording me and laughing at me. It's impossible to get up on your own unless someone helps you.
Fuck it, because you know what? You guys are awesome. Is that doing it? Oh, grandma is here, but you guys are way fucking...
Are you ready?
Hey, go forward.
Yep. Oh, yeah. Oh, we got that shit.